हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, मायसेल्फ सिद्धेश्वर बी तुळजापुरे, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टॉपिक इट इज फ्लो थ्रू द पाईप्स इन सिरीज. द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस सेशन, ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टुडंट्स विल बी एबल टू राईट अन इक्वेशन टू कॅल्क्युलेट head loss in compound pipes, that is the pipes in series. The contents are the definition of pipes in series, the pipes in series connecting two tanks we will see, then we will go for the calculation of head loss in pipes in series considering minor losses, then we will see the calculation of head loss in pipes in series neglecting minor losses, and lastly the references. Now let us see firstly the pipes in series. So these are also named as compound pipes. So pipes in series or compound pipes are defined as the pipes of different lengths and different diameters, so connected end to end in series, that is to form a pipeline. Means what we are having is we are having the pipes of different lengths and different diameters connected end to end. Say end to end it is going to form a series to form a pipeline. So complete pipeline we are going to form means the pipes of different diameters and lengths we are having. So these are joined end to end. So that is going to become compound pipe. As these are joined end to end, so that is named as pipes in series. Now let us see the compound pipe. It is connected to the two tanks. We are having one tank on the left hand side, we are having one tank on the right hand side. Say these two tanks, these are connected to each other with the help of a compound pipe or pipes in series. Now in case of these, you might observe that we are having the firstly the diameter as larger, then the diameter it is reduced, and still again the diameter it is reduced for the third section. But not necessarily always we will have the reduction in the diameter when we are going from the first tank to the second tank. It is, we may have any diameter for any of the sections, and say only thing is the diameters these are different and the connections these are end to end, because of that one, so this will be called as pipes in series or it will be called as compound pipe. Now see again what we have done is we have taken the two tanks which are at different elevations. So the tank it is say on the left hand side it is at higher elevation, the tank on the right hand side it is say at lower elevation. So we are having now the connection between these two. So here now compound pipe you can observe. So the first section it is of larger diameter, then the second section it is of smaller diameter, and we are having again the larger diameter for the third section. So as I said earlier, so the diameter should be different. So that is what the condition is for the compound pipes, and end to end connections should be there. So that is there. So now in case of this one, we are having the pipe diameter of the middle one as lesser, so first one to some extent larger, and third one also it is to some extent larger. Now the notations which we are going to use is, so it is L will be used for the length of the pipe, D it is the diameter of the pipe, so small f it is coefficient of friction of pipe, then V is the velocity of the flow of liquid, then suffix 1, 2, 3 these are going to represent the pipe sections in the compound pipe, and capital H we are going to have the difference in level of liquid in the two tanks it is. Now think of whether the difference in levels of liquids in the two tanks is due to the difference in elevations of the tanks. So now the question you can observe. So the question is, we are having the difference in level of the liquid in the two tanks. So already the tanks at different elevations. So whether the difference in the level is due to the difference in the elevation of the tanks. So I will show you again the diagram. See this diagram. we are now having here the level of the liquid in the say left hand side tank, it is say here, and in the right hand side tank the level is somewhere here. So this difference we are having, the level difference, as it is h. And what the question is, the question is whether this difference in level of the liquids in the two tanks is due to the difference in the elevations of the tanks. Think of the same. See the answer. The answer is no. The difference in levels of the liquid is due to the losses in the pipes connecting the two tanks. It is. See, we are having the liquid level as always, say, horizontal. It is. Say, in case of these two tanks, it is not like this. The two tanks are there and these are connected with the help of the pipes. And the further things are somewhat like this. The liquid, it is going to come from somewhere else in the tank number one. Then it will pass through the pipes. Then it will go to the second tank. And from second tank, it is going somewhere else. So it is not like that, it is stored. So in case of the stored one, the liquid levels, these are going to be same. So in case when the flow is occurring at that time, we are going to have the difference in the, say, level of the liquids in the two tanks. Now, the head loss we are going to consider. The head loss, now it is going to be of two types. One, it is corresponding to the major loss, that is called as frictional loss. The second one, we are having it as a minor loss. So minor losses, these are, say, at connections between the tank and pipes. So the tank is, it is, say, pipes, these are connected to the tanks. So there we are having the minor losses. And one at one more place, that is, when the two pipes of different diameters, these are connected to each other, so there also we are going to have the, say, minor losses. So major loss, minor loss, like that, two types of the losses are there. So major loss, it is, say, considerable. Minor loss, it is having lesser value and of less significance. Say these two types of the losses, these are there, so that you remember. Now again, the same diagram I have drawn here, say I have taken, and we will now go for the equation corresponding to the head loss in pipes, say, considering minor losses. It is. Now, if you look towards the diagram, remember this minor loss definition and the things we talked about it. So, minor losses, these are due to the change in the direction, change in the cross section, etc. we are having. So, here you can observe that the pipe, it is connected to the tank. So here one minor loss, it is going to occur. Then, so through the first pipe section, we are going to have the liquid flow. So major loss will be there. Again, sudden contraction we are having of the pipe. So here minor loss, it is going to occur. So again, frictional loss in the section 2, we are going to have. Then sudden expansion, it is going to occur. So we are going to have again minor loss. Then the frictional loss in the section 3. And lastly, again, the section 3 pipe, it is connected to the tank. So at that joint, again, we are going to have the, say, minor loss. Corresponding to the formulae of the minor losses, say, minor losses due to the, say, sudden expansion, minor losses due to the sudden contraction, etc. And, say, minor losses at the connection between the tank and the pipe, etc. So you can write the equation. So the first one, it is H is equal to head loss, H is equal to, so it is 0.5 V1 square by 2G. So it is the first minor loss. The first pipe, it is connected to the, say, tank, say, left hand side tank there. Then it is major loss, 4 F1 L1 V1 square by, it is 2G D1. Then it is 0.5 V2 square by 2G. So it is corresponding to the sudden contraction. Then major loss corresponding to section second. So it is 4 F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2. Then sudden expansion, it is occurring. So loss corresponding to that one, it is V2 minus V3 bracket square we are having and divided by 2G. And plus it is 4 F3 L3 V3 square by 2G D3. So it is major loss in the section 3. And lastly, again, section 3 is connected to the second tank. So there it is V3 square by 2G is going to be the loss, which is minor loss. Then if you neglect the minor loss, because minor losses, these are of lesser significant, less value these are having. So if you remove these minor losses, we are going to come across only the major losses. In case of major loss, so only corresponding to these three different sections we are going to write. So it will be H is equal to, it is 4F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus 4F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2 plus 4F3 L3 V3 square by 2G D3. These are the references which are used for this particular session. Thank you.